cemetery stamps and the cementless stamps. So what is the difference between cemetery stamps mostly used in the older age patient and cementless stamps are used in the younger ones. So I talk about in the modern hip replacement operation, cementless stamp basically mostly made of cobalt holy matter, but in the cementless stamps it is made of titanium. These are basically this is the stem. This part is the stem, and this part is the femoral stem, and this cup is basically the acetabular cup. These are different shapes of the stem. The next one, these are furthermore shapes of the stems, and we can also study in our few papers like titanium and cobalt chromium implants are widely recognized for their high biocompatibility, and they have very very minimal risk of the reaction with the human body. The second component is the cup. Basically, this cup is the acetabular cup. Further, it is made of two metals like tantalum and titanium. So, further, they provide very good surfaces for bone attachment. The third component is the ball. The ball is also we call the femoral head, and there are different femoral head sizes as you can see. Like we can adjust this according to the patient age. And the third component is the liner. Liner is basically it is inserted into the cup, and like it serves as our like new cartilage. Basically, cartilage is in between the two bone, which helps in the movement. So if you talk about in our like real cartilage, so it is just like the cartilage in our the hip joint. The next one is clinical results. So it proves that why I use this technique THA. So it has some advantage, like before surgery, no, in fact after surgery, like the doctor asked like their patients after 2.5 years, and the result shows that almost 806 patients recovered by this surgery and the technique. The technique which I discussed in the previous slide, THA, which is the total hip arthroplasty. And we have seen that like more than 50 years or like under 40 to 50 years recovered this after this treatment and after by using this technique. On the other hand, they examined before this technique, by using this technique, 20% people and patient are not able to do anything, like they are not able to go their regular job. So, but after this surgery and by using this technique, they see only 3% patient are not able to do walk or anything. But on the other hand, 97% successfully return to their jobs. The next one is the biocompatibility and device modularity. Biocompatibility material is the important factor. It can be defined as it is a substance utilized to treat the devices, like it should be reliable, safety, economical, and physiological, replace a part or function of any human body on the part. There are further two materials like bio-inert materials and the bioactive materials. So what is the difference between these materials? Bio-inert materials are those which have very minimal interaction with the surrounding tissue, and bioactive materials are those which have maximum interaction with the surrounding tissue. Mostly we use basically bio-inert materials mostly used in the younger patients. And there are some examples of the bio-inert materials like stainless steel, titanium, aluminium, and the polymer is which is ultra high nuclear with polyethylene. The next one, there are some material properties and material selection, and after these using these materials we have see some challenges. I will discuss here also. The first one, material is metal. So cobalt, chromium, molybdenum, they are further classified into two primary categories, the cast wise and the rogue wise. So what will happen, cast wise exhibit a it has